was afvraag. En ik vind het heel mooi dat Wilhelmina solo tentoonstelling heeft. We hebben alleen maar knotgekke, volle groepstentoonstellingen waar de stapel staat. Mensen met een hele museale solo, een prachtig werk. En dan gaan we om te beginnen eerst natuurlijk met Sadiq praten. Waar ben je? Sadiq, can I invite you to the stage?
He said a lot of things.
things, a lot of different things, but I think at the core of your exhibition lies the language and the notion of language, which takes us beyond language actually. It's not only words that we see here, it's mostly images, but they are a language to you. That is why the whole evening will be about different forms of language, different shapes of language can take. I would like to ask you to turn to that word, because you said that was really important to start with, I am a manuscript. Why is this man a manuscript? Is it you? And it's made us and made us into the exhibition.
Yeah, okay, thank you very much. Nice to meet you all. I think it's better to say something before we talk about this work, about the whole concept. It started with the idea of the language. What should I do with the language? In the beginning, I was thinking to try something with the difficulty of the Dutch language. In the beginning, someone, a friend, suggested me to call it, for example, I was even thinking to make a video with this word, Frischtekkewik, trying to announce it many times. But the concept developed in my mind because I was always thinking about the language as a kind of box we are inside it, and we cannot in any way, anyhow, to get out of this box. We have no choice to be outside the language, because the language is shaped us, and there is no way to practice anything beyond the language. We are actually the language. And this meaning, this work, saying I am the manuscript. Why manuscript? It could be any other word. I can say I am the language, I am the images, I am the meanings, I am the words, anything. But I choose to use, manuscripts, because I believe that in our mind, there is many levels of language. Even if you live in one country, in one place, and you speak one language, you will have levels, because the language you read in the books, not the same as the language you talk in the street, and each one of them has a layer. This layer is like books, like all books. So if you look to your mind deeply, you will see a lot of this kind of layers, like manuscripts. Yeah. So I am a manuscript. So.
And, of course, it's important also to mention that you have several languages. You come from Farsi, from Iran. You left the Arabic. Sorry, that's the Arabic, and but you lived. I counted like more than half your life now in Poland. Almost, it's like half. So there's the English and the Dutch as well. The Arabic, as Abulkan says, is the base. But these different languages, you told me it's so interesting that even if you think of the same word, if you think of it in a different language, it's a completely different thing.
Yes, yes.
Can you give an example of that?
Yes, look, to understand that we should say that the language, it's not only the words, the alphabet, okay? The language is everything, actually. Anything around us has a kind of language. So, and the language, our mind is trying to visualize all the language we see, we hear, we read, okay? say a tree, so you would imagine here a tree. When you say a table, there's a table. Which table? There's a lot of shapes of tables. It's a kind of general table that we are talking here in somehow like the language of Plato. Okay? So there is something always a shape of everything, even if you talk about things, meaning things like justice.
معرض بعنوان لغة تحت جلدي، واللي كنت أريد أقوله بهذا الأعمال كلها هو أنه إحنا لا يمكن بأي شكل من الأشكال أن نوجد خارج اللغة. إحنا في الواقع موجودين داخل اللغة. اللغة هي اللي تشكلنا، وهي اللي تصنع كل أنواع الليبلز اللي تكون أدمغتنا ورؤيتنا للعالم. يعني لا يمكن أن نتخيل وجودنا خارج عن اللغة، حتى لو محاولاتنا من خلال الفن والشعر مثلا، احنا نحاول أن نخرج خارج اللغة. يعني الشعر مثلا بتكسيره لقواعد اللغة واللعب على 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 معاني الكلمات، يحاول الشاعر هنا ان يذهب الى ما بعد. بس اللي اريد اقوله انه الشاعر حتى بهذه المحاوله للخروج من 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 قوالب اللغه لصناعه عالم اخر خارج حدود اللغه المحكيه المعروفه، هو بالواقع محاولته للتحرر من اللغة هي باستخدام اللغة نفسها. يعني أنا أحاول أتحرر من اللغة باللغة نفسها، أوكي؟ وبالتالي أنا في كل الحالات موجود داخل اللغة، ولا يمكن أن أعيش أي تجربة حياتية أو ذاتية أو رؤيوية أو ما إلى ذلك خارج حدود اللغة. هذا المعرض محاولة يعني من عندي للحديث عن هذا المفهوم. إيزي على الجسد هنا بهذا المعرض، لأنه يعني إذا أتتبع اللغة أنا راح أصل إلى الدماغ، وبالتالي المصنع أو الستيشن اللي المحطة اللي تتجمع فيها كل خيوط اللغة بكل أشكالها وأنواعها هي الدماغ. هذا من جهة، ومن جهة ثانية الجسدي نفسه، هو جسدنا هو عبارة عن لغة، أوكي؟ فأنا لا يمكن أن أنظر للغة إلا باعتبارها شكل، إيمج، صورة. هذه الصورة حاولت هنا أن أصل إليها من خلال الجسد نفسه.